Hello viewers, this is Kumar Pratyush and welcome to my channel Educhem Discovery. Viewers, today we are going to start a new series of discussion on class 12th syllabus of Maharashtra Board. In the current situation of the lockdown, students are facing a lot of problem while studying the syllabus of class 12. Big friends, today we are going to start with the topic Introduction Polymer Chemistry as our starting and inaugurating chapter. The page number that you have to refer for this is 331 to 345. I am just taking those page number that includes the chapter content and I am exempting the exercise in the session. So let's start. So viewers, this is the particular overview. Introduction to Polymer Chemistry. As understanding the title of the chapter, Introduction to Polymer Chemistry, the word polymer itself is a big word because it is completely related to a wide variety of agents and objects and substances that we daily use but we are unaware of. The learning outcome of this chapter definitely relates and revolves around the center topic that the students must understand the application and improvisation of polymers in their general life. So friends, let's start with the definition. The definition of polymer, as you can see that the chemically polymers are complex giant macromolecule made up from repeating units of derived small molecules. Now, when we talk about repetitive unit, so repetitive unit means when we are talking about long linkages. Long linkages means a linkages of a similar monomer or a similar unit that is repeating n number of times. The word poly itself refers to a number more than 3. To understand the concept of polymer, so what I will demonstrate, just this is the benzene ring. Now this benzene ring can be attached or fused in this arm and now it is getting converted into a naphthalene ring. Despite of that, what happens if it is attached in a chain like this and this complete section of that is a biphenyl, it is repeating n number of times. Like if we are telling it is repeating n number of times. So you can see that I will demonstrate, like this is the, suppose this is an ethane molecule and it is repeating n number of times. So you can see, like you can see, I have drawn a structure. So let's understand the formation of polymer. Suppose I chosen a carbon and this is the particular structure of ethene. Now what I am doing, I am applying a polymerization sign on this and this is a particular representation of a polymer. So what does it mean? This particular unit is repeating n number of times, so this complete molecule can be told as a polymer. So what we understand that a benzene ring can also be a monomer if it is repeating n number of times, if it is repeating and forming a complete chain. like you can see, it is repeating n number of times, so it can also be called as a polymer. So friends, this is all about the definition of the polymer. Coming to the important history about the polymers, you can see the Staudinger, that is, he won the Nobel Prize in 1953 for his discovery of polymeric substances, and further from there, 1953, the complete chain of discoveries related to polymers started. Coming to the important topic again, that is included and very important for polymer understanding, is classification of polymers. Here you can see that the polymers can be classified on the basis of five types, that is, on their source, on their chemical substances or structures, their mode of polymerization, their molecular forces, and finally the type of monomers and biodegradability. Now these types of classification will be discussed in brief. Now let's start with the first, that is classification of polymer on the basis of source or origin. Friends, already we understand that there are all the substances have at least minimum two sources, that is, it some substance can be from the plant source and some substance can be achieved from the animal source. This is what we have learned till now in other scientific subjects. But here where we are also introducing the synthetic chemistry, which completely deals with the manufacturing or creation of the product in a lab. In a lab, the word lab means a lab is a very sophisticated place which is completely assigned for such researches. So polymers are further divided into three types, that is natural polymer, synthetic polymer and semi-synthetic polymer. On this basis, let's start from the natural polymer. Now natural polymers, if we talk about, so natural polymers are definitely those polymers that are obtained from the plant or the animal source. Like if we talk about cotton, if we talk about linen, so these are those examples that will deal with the plant origin polymers. The best example, that is natural rubber, is again one of the polymer that has been used by the persons several of persons of several sectors to you that has been used by several sectors and persons for satisfying their needs. The animal polymers have example like silk, wool, and everyone is quite aware about their uses. Coming to the synthetic polymers, now the word synthetic, I already mentioned earlier that the word synthetic polymer deals with the those polymers that can be synthesized or manufactured or prepared in the lab. Now on this basis, synthetic polymers are further classified into one monomer, dimer, trimer. Now these are those polymers that includes the number of repeating unit in them. Examples of this are several fibers and plastics which are used by daily basis. Coming to the third type on classification of polymer based on origin is semi-synthetic polymer. Students, I will demonstrate one of the example very precisely to understand the semi-synthetic polymer. Suppose this is a benzene ring. Suppose this is a benzene ring and we have obtained this benzene from a natural source. What I did, I just substituted one of the amino group in my lab and converted this naturally occurred benzene into a synthetic substance. So now it is known as aniline and it becomes a semi-synthetic compound. So what I did, I obtained the benzene from the natural source, I took into my lab and carried out a particular set of experiment for substitution of amino group on the benzene, and further it led to the formation of an aniline product. Now, in our context, such type of product will be called as a semi-synthetic product or polymers. Means, again I am showing the example. Semi-synthetic polymers are derived from the natural polymer, but they are treated in a synthetic lab. So, example of that is very easy to understand by the synthetic shirts which are double shaded in color, or the party wear shirts. Friends, if you observe them clearly and closely, they are also made up of fibers which are included for normal manufacturing of normal shirts also. The difference between the two, party wear shirts with shadings or the shirts with normal single color, is the mixing of the shades of the fibers. In this case, the shading into the normal fiber is induced by adsorbing some kind of pigments on those fibers. One more example to understand the concept of semi-synthetic polymers is, in the students love to flew their kite and usually coat their threads or manja with the glass powder. Now what they did, initially they used the normal manja that was purchased by n number of students, but they treated their manja with that glass powder to make it more sharper, and so that they can easily win the competition of kite flying. So this is what the concept of semi-synthetic polymer explains. Coming to the next classification basis, that is classification of polymers on structure. Depending upon the structure, that is chemical structure, the polymers are classified into further types based on their branching. Like a linear shaped or straight chain polymers include a straight chain linkages. Like I will demonstrate that. Here we can see that it is, what is happening? I'm just enlarging the, it is a straight chain. Now you can see that it is not a branching, it is just straight because there is no branching has occurred. So this is what a linear chain or linear polymer explains. Diagrammatic representation of a linear polymer is shown in the figure A. Coming to the second type, that is branched polymer, in this case the branching occurs and it leads to formation of certain linkages. The example of that is low density polythene or plastics. You can currently, if you are well known, the Maharashtra government has banned the initially used plastic or poly bags due to its thickness and has introduced a guideline to use the poly bags or the plastic bags of a prescribed thickness. Now, low density polythenes are those polythenes that was initially used, but now it has been replaced by good quality of plastics. Now, what again I will demonstrate the same by, you can see what happens in this case is that, now this was the initial substitution. What I did, I carried out a branching and this chain is going. Now this branching again links with another chain and the chain is going. So you can see that the two chains, the two linear chains are attached by this branching carbon. So this is an example of branched polymers that can be understood by this diagrammatic representation. Coming to the third type and a complex type, which is cross-linked polymers, which includes a polyfunctional monomers to form peptide chains or some kind of initial important chains to form cross-linking and lead to formation of certain products. The example of such cross-linkings are bakelite, which is used in certain gaskets. It has been also used for the handle of the pressure cooker, etc. Melanin is also used in several cases. Coming to the next classification of polymers, that is on the basis of mode of polymerization. The mode of polymerization or the polymerization process is basically divided into two broad types by which the polymerization takes place. First type is addition polymerization, or it is also called as chain growth polymerization, and the second type is condensation polymerization, or it is also called as step growth polymerization. Further, one more polymerization technique, that is ring opening polymerization, has been introduced recently. The addition reaction usually includes the breakdown of the carbon-carbon double bond, and that leads to opening of a valency of individual carbon and leads to further attachments. Usually these attachments are preferable to be a positive and a negative entity, which is easily understood by the Markovnikov and anti-Markovnikov rules earlier. Now, coming to the addition polymerization, the mechanism is quite simple. All the polymerization process, which includes a carbon-carbon double bond getting converted into carbon-carbon single bond, will definitely include the mechanism of addition polymerization and the basic mechanism or the chemical mechanism included in these type is free radical substitution of the entities by the addition reaction, that is breakdown of carbon-carbon double bond. This free radical mechanism is divided into few steps, that is chain initiating step, next chain propagating step and chain termination step. In the chain initiating step, you can see that it includes a formation of new radical by the breakdown of carbon-carbon double bond and addition of a new free radical to one of the carbon. Chain propagating step includes the increase of the size of the chain by carrying out the same reaction of addition mechanism n number of time. So you can see this was our radical which was formed by the step 1. This radical is reacting with a new molecule and leading to formation of a higher chain radical. Students, this process can be carried out n number of times so that we can get the desired length of polymers. Finally, the chain termination step includes the termination of the polymerization process and formation of a polymer of desired chain size. So the free radical mechanism was divided into three types or three steps, which is chain initiating, chain propagating and chain terminating. Coming to the next polymerization process, that is condensation polymerization process. The word condensation is always linked with condensing of two or more chains. Now students, a key note to remember with the word of condensation is all the molecules definitely will condense to form a new molecule, but they will emit out small molecules like water, ethanol, etc. Now we can understand by the following example, like ethylene glycol. This is the structure of ethylene glycol. The terephthalic acid is going to condense with ethylene glycol. What happens is hydrogen of the acid and OH of the ethylene glycol is removed in form of water and the molecule is condensed. Here we can again see and understand this concept. Here we can see that if I'm including a carbon chain like this, so what happens, this is basically acetic acid. Now in the case, and I am using one of the alcohols, what will happen is this OH and this H, this OH and this H will be removed in form of water and lead to condensation of these two molecules. Now the condensation will lead to formation of carbon this will be linked with again one more carbon, which is representing this carbon particularly. Next, a oxygen, which is representing this particular oxygen. Now, students, you can see that only hydrogen of one of the entities have been removed. So we can understand by this, usually the acid moiety releases its hydrogen due to its acidic property and leads to formation of ester. Now, what happens here? The oxygen is there and the carbon, this carbon is further substituted to this oxygen. So this is the product, desired product of a condensation of these two molecules. So it can be very easily understood, hydrogen from this acid, OH from the alcohol is being removed in form of water, and further the CH3 gets attached to the oxygen of the acid. So here water is the removing group, and usually it can be water or it can be methanol, ethanol or smaller compounds that will lead to the formation of such condensation products. So here also we can see that this ester linkage is formed and water molecule has been removed. Coming to the third type of condensation, that is polymerization, that is ring opening polymerization. Now students, this ring opening polymerization usually take place in the case of lactones. This is particularly a lactone ring. You have might seen this interaction in case of penicillin structure. In that also this lactone ring is present. What happens in this case is that the breakdown of this nitrogen and carbon bond take place, and this breakdown further leads to formation of a straight chain compound or a polymer. So ring opening polymerization type of reaction will definitely include ring opening and breakdown of carbon and nitrogen, or carbon with another hetero atom and linkage to be breakdown and get converted into a open chain structure. So this is all about the polymerization process, and the polymers are classified into three types, that is addition polymerization, condensation polymerization and ring opening polymerization. Coming to the fourth type of classification of polymers, that is classification of polymers based on the intermolecular forces. Now students, the intermolecular forces, the word inter means the interaction between the two different entities. If it was the word of intra, that must have included the in situ interaction. Now, as it is the intermolecular forces, definitely it will lead to certain enhanced properties in the molecules. Like the mechanical properties of the polymers, such as tensile strength, toughness, elasticity, differ widely depending upon the intermolecular forces. That means if the intermolecular forces is high and the strength or the nature of these forces is high, that will lead to enhancement of the tensile strength, toughness and other properties also. Example are elastomers. The word elastomer comes from the word elasticity. The word elasticity refers to the ability of a compound or a object to restore its original strength or shape by in situ forces. Now, the example is rubber band. If we stretch a rubber band and leave it, automatically the rubber band retains its shape until and unless we didn't apply an extraordinary force to it. The next example is, or the category is, fiber. Now, the word fiber is usually understood by a long linear longitudinal linkages like you have seen in the sugar cane. Now, sugar cane is the best example. Everyone has seen particularly the structure of sugar cane. It includes thin fibers that can be easily seen after we have squeezed it up for the juice. These fibers definitely increases the resistance and their tension so that it makes them more strong. The examples are nylon threads, which are used in daily purpose for several utilities like drying the clothes. Such nylon threads are used in the household, but the modified ones are used in several industries for diversified uses. Coming to the next polymer, that is thermoplastic polymer. The word plastic means a ability to remold. Ability to remold. The plasticity is a property of being easily shaped or remolded. So the best example is, you have seen the water bottles, that is are normal mineralized water bottle. Several companies have several shapes of water bottle, but it is made up of similar type of plastic only. So actually the content of each and every bottle is almost similar, but the difference is only in their shape. Coming to the next type of polymer, that is thermosetting. The word setting in itself means it is definitely resistant to change in shape. Such type of polymers do not change or do not fuse to be remolded like the thermoplastic polymers. Example of this, you have definitely seen the plastic of your water tanks overhead of your house. They are also made up of polymer and plastic, but the normal plastic of your water bottle and the thermosetting and the water tank is different. So you can understand, these are gaskets which are used, bakelites. Again, you can understand the use of bakelite in pressure cooker handles and other non-stick pan handles. Finally, the fifth type of classification of polymer is classification of polymer on the basis of different monomers. If it is homo, that means same, it is called as homopolymers. But if it is different, then such type of polymer is known as copolymers. So this is the overview of the discussion, the final and last basis of classification is classification of polymers on the basis of biodegradability. The word biodegradability is very important in current era because we are definitely dealing with those approaches that heals the mother nature and do not affect in adverse way. The biodegradable polymers are those polymers that have the ability to be degraded in the environment after a time. But non-biodegradable polymers do not degrade to the environment and hence they may lead to certain adverse effects. This is the short overview of classification of polymers. So students, it is understood that the polymers are classified into five types, that is based on its source, structure, molecular forces, polymerization, mode of polymerization and number of monomers, and finally the biodegradability. Now these six or five types, that is when we are talking about six type, we are including the biodegradability, but normally the biodegradable polymers is a property, not a basis to classify. It is a particularly property of the product, whether it belongs to biodegradable class or non-biodegradable class. So we can abbreviate this for memorizing as SSMPNB. So it is SSMPNB. S for source or origin, S for structure, M for molecular forces, P for polymerization, next N for number of monomers, and last but not the least, B for biodegradability. So the word becomes SSMPNB. So stay tuned with our channel for continuing the session. Thank you for today.